there. Today we're going to talk about the new European application that you're going to have to do in 2024 to go to the 30 different European countries. So let's talk about that. My name is RoseAnne. Thank you so much for joining me today. And welcome to those of you that are new and my loyal subscribers. I'm really grateful for you to be here. Thank you so much. So the ETIAS is called the European Travel Information and Authorization System. Now, this is not a visa. And this is going to go into effect for all European countries, 30 of them, starting in 2024. But it is not in place yet, and we don't know when it's going to be in place. So we need to keep our eye on this new regulation. So let's break it down and talk about what this regulation is. Well, first of all, it's not a visa. It's a way for the European Union to keep track of the visitors to make sure that they can decrease the risk of terrorism, because those are, you know, that's a very big concern. So they want to make sure who comes in and out. They want to check to make sure if there's any illegal people coming into the European country, so they have a better understanding of who comes in and out. So that's the reason why they developed this program. And they started working on this quite a few years ago, and then with COVID, it got delayed, but they're going to be rolling it out in 2024 sometime. The other thing that we really need to be concerned about is that when you do fill out this application, when it's time for you to go to a European country, you want to make sure you get to the correct website. So there's going to be only one website, and that's going to be the official website through the European Union. But there already are some websites that are mimicking that. So I wanted you to be aware of that. So what this application form is all about, or how you fill it out and what does it mean, is it's an electronic form only. So it's not a visa where you're going to have to, you know, get permission to get into the country. You're going to go in, fill out this form electronically. You can do it on the computer. You can do it on your phone. It's going to cost about $8. Once you get approved, then your approval will last for 3 years, as long as your passport that you used for the application is valid. And when you're filling out the application, your passport needs to have more than 3 months on it. So if your passport is going to expire in 3 months, then you're not going to be able to apply for this application. Which brings me to another point. If your passport has 6 months left on it, you should be starting the renewal process, because that'll help you manage any issues, because they want to make sure that you have plenty of time on your passport. So what this also helps to regulate is to make sure that when you're in the country, you are there short term. So you can really only be in the European countries for 90 days within 180 days. So they want to keep track and make sure that you're not staying there longer than 90 days in 180 days. At one time. So this application is not about staying in Europe long term. You really should fill out this application 1 month before you're planning to go to Europe. Ordinarily, from what I've read, is you're going to be able to get approval within minutes once you go and fill out the application. If there's a problem, it could delay your approval process. So if you know you're going to Europe, then just make sure that you fill out the application a month before. Now, if you work with a travel agent, they can also help you fill out the application. There could be a third party filling the form out for you. So that's really important to know. Not sure if I mentioned it's going to cost about $8 to fill out this application, depending on the European Euro exchange. Now, some people are thinking, well, what if I don't fill out this form? What if I just go and I don't fill out the form? Well, it's attached to your passport. If you're going through customs or you're going to get there, if your passport is not connected to this ETIAS form, then you're not going anywhere. So they're going to really keep track of it. So it's going to be really important that you fill out this form, that you pay attention to when it comes out, which leads me to another point. If you don't have a travel agent who's monitoring this for you, then you can go to the travel.state.gov website, and in that website, it's going to be updated for you. And that website also has a lot of information. It tells you which countries need visas, which country, the European countries that are going to need that ETIAS authorization form. It'll tell you if there are any security risks in any country. And you can register on that site so that if anything should happen while you're traveling in that location, you would be contacted and you would be notified of any issues that would happen in the country that you're traveling. So it's a really great website to check out so that you can be updated on the area that you're going to. So I just wanted to hop on and do just a really quick video describing what this new form is going to be about. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of information coming down the pike around this. I do know that the UK is going to be doing something very similar, probably not until 2025. But in the meantime, hopefully a lot of people are going to Europe and they're going to be enjoying a beautiful vacation. But make sure that you fill out that form. And keep watching this channel because I'll definitely be giving you updates. And as soon as I learn when they're coming, when it's going to be in effect, I'll definitely let you know. So I hope this has been helpful and that it's going to provide you with the right information. And I'll keep you updated on the new terms once I am apprised of it. So have a really great day and ciao for now. Bye.